And because, particularly my district, and even more so Rodney Alexander's district, 5th district, are mainly rural areas, we have to encompass even more geography than before. That's why we stretch all the way from Arkansas down here to St. Andrew Parish. And it's important that you understand that we're not going to treat you any differently than if you run across the street from us in Mendon, Louisiana. I practiced medicine for 36 years and then still see patients when I get a chance to. Mendon is a town of 13,000 in a rural parish. And we've got a lot of the same problems that I know Evangeline has because we just came from there with regard to school system issues, meeting budgets, and all that. So there are a lot of commonalities. And so I'm not from Shreveport, Bossier. I'm from a small town much like this. And these are the kind of things that that we've lived with for some decades. So in an overall theme of Washington, I'm a conservative Republican. I'm a constitutionalist. I believe that the Constitution provides laws that protect citizens from government rather than government from citizens, which is unique in history if you think about it. The countries before us, before our experiment we call American democracy, laws were all about protecting the sovereign. So we were unique in saying, no, it's the citizens who need protecting, not the government itself. But I think in many ways we've migrated away from that. And that's one of the things we need to look at going forward in Washington, is what is it that we're doing as a government to be coercive towards our citizens? And of course, I have to tell you that I opposed and voted against Obamacare. I feel that Obamacare is a coercive healthcare system that's government run that tells you how to live your personal life. And I just don't think that's the American way. And as a physician, I can tell you that's not the best way, the most effective way to deliver healthcare. And there are other issues with regard. I know that this area is more heavily Catholic than in North Louisiana. And I'm working with the Catholic bishops on the coercion issue about abortifacients, which are pills that can cause abortions, and on sterilization and other things that under Obamacare, healthcare providers will be required to participate in things that are against their conscience. And again, the First Amendment protects us from having to do things that are against not only our religious beliefs, but our moral beliefs. We feel like there's a tremendous overreach today from some of the laws and regulations that have come down in Washington that do that. So we have a lot of things, I think, to reform. I think we're on a reform pathway because we've gone way too far down the road of excessive and onerous regulations. I hear it every day. I talk to farmers. I talk to factory owners and factory managers, people from small businesses, people from large businesses. And they tell me that these are the things that keep them up at night. Number one is, again, Obamacare. What is this going to mean for our bottom line, or are we going to have a bottom line? Number two is not only the regulations that we're having to meet, which we don't know how we're going to meet them, but what are the regulations going to be in 6 months that we don't even know about yet? And those regulations are being written by bureaucrats in Washington, not by Congress. We're on automatic pilot when it comes to writing regulations.